let's take another look at whether it is static data or data in transmission or data in use. That is, in the whole process of data processing, we need to consider its security. This is why we need to set security requirements for the object. That is, we need to establish security requirements for data assets. So what are the requirements for secure processing? Let's see what we need to pay attention to. So first of all, whether it is physical or logical, we need to control the assets, right? Because our equipment is tangible assets, including our data, including our software is intangible assets. So both physical and logical need to be controlled. Here is the second point. When the data is not encrypted, then there is a lack of digital and traceable means. That is to say, the data must be encrypted. At the beginning of this chapter, we mentioned that we need to label, we need to mark the data. Actually, the process of labeling, we can consider it as encrypting data with different levels of keys. In that case, when my object is encrypted, then my subject must use the corresponding key of my object. Then we can access it. Which subjects use these keys? In the process of its use, how is it processed or how is it transmitted? Then we can track it. So the key to this is the confidentiality of the data, that is, the encryption of the key we mentioned. It provides the security features of the entire data. Everyone understands this, especially for sensitive information. Confidentiality certainly needs to be protected. Only when confidentiality is protected. Can we provide other security features of the data, the encrypted data, from a physical perspective? For example, like our USB flash drive or this portable hard drive, we also need to make a physical label. That is, we also need to label it physically to identify or to inform this is a sensitive data corresponding to the sensitivity level. And sometimes in the exam, he once asked such a question. He said, in an environment, we found that the surrounding data is labeled. When a medium is found without a label, it should be treated as the highest sensitivity level of information medium. Everyone understands this. If my surrounding data is labeled, according to common sense or reason, my data should also be labeled. But because of my improper handling or negligence, as a result, my data is not labeled. It could be such a situation. In this case, then I first assume that my data is of high sensitivity level. I let the subject with high sensitivity level confirm and check what level this data is. If it is indeed a high sensitivity level, then my handling is not a problem because I am looking for a subject with high sensitivity. But if my data is of low sensitivity level, that's not a problem either. Because I let a subject with high sensitivity level look at it first. It does not involve leakage. It is inherently sensitive. That is, the level of the subject is relatively high. So it does not involve leakage. But what I'm afraid of is that I should label, but I forgot. Then my data is of high sensitivity level. But you say, right, let a subject with low sensitivity level verify it first. Then there is a problem. The data is leaked. So we need to know this. If a data surrounding data of the same level have been marked and he didn't, then we first handle it at the highest level. Everyone can understand this security logic. And in the process of handling, only authorized personnel can handle objects of corresponding levels. And in this place, for those who handle and use data, we need to train him on security policies and procedures. He must have this security awareness. Otherwise, my data is very secure. But in the process of his use, he may not pay much attention to these security strategies and procedures. For example, in the process of use, the person may leave the computer without locking the screen. In this case, during his handling, data is also easily leaked. So on one hand, we need to provide security technically. On the other hand, the management of people's awareness is equally important. Emphasize this again here. Management of people is also very important. From the perspective of storage, since our data has been labeled, then physically we should also put it in a secure container where is the safest place. If it is top secret data, we can save it in the bank's vault because the bank's vault is the safest place. Everyone needs to understand this. That is from the perspective of storage. We also mentioned before about destruction. If data can't be simply destroyed, it should go through a process. What should be cleared, or we use eradication, right? The highest level of treatment, that is destruction, for example, death, or the whole phase change of our hardware. So this is a whole set of processes from the generation of data to the transmission, storage, processing of data, to finally destroying the data. It's a whole process. We need to consider the protection of the entire data. Because in the whole process of data processing, if there is a problem at any point or time period, then the data will leak. So it is a protection of the whole life cycle. And in the whole life cycle of our data processing, these processing procedures, including the traces we mentioned, should be recorded. Because later he needs to trace and audit our data processing. We can see the whole process of data flow and the process of security protection. And also there is one more thing, if the life cycle of the data expires, then this data, from the perspective of preservation, it has no value and meaning for preservation. What should it do then? Don't keep data beyond the limit. Then the data should be properly and securely destroyed. That is to say, if the data, it has exceeded its life cycle. In other words, this data has no value or significance in its usage process. It has already lost its value and meaning, so it should be properly handled. Why has this become a no man's land data? If we haven't destroyed these data yet, it is very likely that we will archive it, just put it in a place, right? A not so important place, we don't care about it, but this data may still be sensitive to our organization. In that case, its leakage may still cause losses, so it cannot be kept beyond the deadline. That is the data that should be used. We should let it provide value if this data has exceeded its life cycle. The data that should be destroyed, destroy it safely. This is also very important. So let's review the second chapter as a whole. It talked about two important things. The first thing is what we said about the basic security requirements for data or data policies, including data grading and classification policies, including data governance policies, including some security policies of data. So this is the first part. The second part is about the life cycle of data and how to provide data security throughout the entire life cycle. We should provide data security, need to do corresponding security protection. For example, how to protect competition data, data and transmission, how do we protect it, including data and transmission. We provided point-to-point encryption, including link encryption, including how we handle business data. So this chapter mainly revolves around the object. One is from the perspective of security policy. From this general perspective, what security requirements does data need? The other is from the perspective of the entire life cycle of data. What kind of protection do we provide? That's all for the introduction of the second chapter.